hope that we can relaunch negotiations through proximity talks in the very near future. We think this is not an end in itself. It is a means to building confidence, beginning the conversation about substantive matters on the core issues that divide the Israelis and the Palestinians, that will, we hope and expect, lead to direct talks.
You did take a bit of a risk, perhaps, when you escalated the tone with Israel last week. Do you think that risk is paying off?
I think we're going to see the resumption of the negotiation track, and that means that it is paying off because that's our goal.
Is the pressure on the Israeli Prime Minister meant to be a moment of clarity? Either he shows his commitment to peace with actions, or his right-wing coalition falls?
I think that sometimes government, different parts of governments make actions or make statements that are not in the best interests of the government as a whole. And I think what the Prime Minister has said repeatedly is his government and he personally are committed to pursuing these negotiations. And he just has to make sure that he brings along everyone else. That's his responsibility. It's not something the United States can or is interested in doing.